name is Lauchlan, and in my spare time I love to play rugby union and rugby sevens here at the University of Queensland for the Red Heavies. Did you know that without natural rubber, rugby union and other forms of rugby will not be able to enjoy the grip, which allows for greater passing accuracy and distance? These are the unique qualities offered by natural rubber, and isoprene is a molecule that natural rubber consists of. Isoprene is a molecule known as a monomer. Monomers are molecules that can be bonded to other molecules that are identical to form polymers. Now this is important because the molecule that natural rubber consists of is a polymer called polyisoprene. Polyisoprene is consisted of a chain of isoprene monomers, which are bonded together through polymerization, which is chemically combining them. Polyisoprene belongs to a group of polymers called elastomers. So what does isoprene look like? This is my three-dimensional model of the molecule isoprene. Isoprene can be expressed in the molecular formula as C5H8, which means it contains 5 carbons, which are represented by these joints, and 8 hydrogen atoms, which are represented by the white balls. Isoprene is also referred to as 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. But what does that mean? It means there's 4 carbons in the parent chain, giving us a buta prefix. It's an alkene because there's presence of double bonds. Because there's 2, it becomes butadiene. Off the second carbon in the parent chain, there's a methyl group, which is this single carbon chain. And you put that all together and you get 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. 1 and the 3 represent the starting point of both those double bonds. Isoprene is an organic molecule and is found in the sap of the para rubber tree, or, as it's scientifically referred to, Hevea brasiliensis. As the name suggests, the para rubber tree originated from Brazil, and isoprene is found in the sap of the tree, which is known as latex. Once latex is harvested, for it to become natural rubber, it must go through a process called vulcanization. Vulcanization of rubber is a chemical process by which the physical properties of natural rubber are improved, and is brought about by heating rubber with sulfur. Essentially, what adding sulfur does to this heat treatment is the formation of crosslinks between isoprene molecules. Rubber that has undergone vulcanization has higher tensile strength and resistance to swelling and abrasion. It is also elastic over a greater range of temperatures. Rubber has been described as the fourth most important natural resource in the world. Vulcanized rubber was a revolutionary breakthrough, and the discovery allowed for the invention of many products that have shaped the modern world today. These products include
tires, windshield wipers, engine mounting, sealing belts, seat belts, seat covers, rubber rods, rubber speed breakers, seals, earthquake resistance buoys, various electrical wires, boots, shoes, soles, balls, gloves, balloons, hot air balloons, floor liners, contact lenses, condoms, silicon breast implants, O-rings, toys, trampolines, hoses, engine linings, gaskets, noise and shock dampers, emulsion paper, adhesives, gums, resins, tank shafts, rubber bullets, masks, fenders, scuba suits, and submarine acoustic suppression lines, and many more.
On top of that, Goodyear's accidental discovery of vulcanization allowed further research, which led to the birth of rubber synthetics, which gave us access to even more products. Now that you know a little bit more about rubber, I hope you can appreciate and enjoy all the things we have in our world today, across many industries, and all thanks to the amazing capabilities of rubber, especially when thrown around a rugby ball.